Welcome to Superior Profit Weekly Market Roundup, 16 December 2017. I am Sagar Nandi, Chief Analyst and Trader at Superior Profit, a company based in Singapore. I will not take time to introduce myself. If you are interested to know more about me, the company Superior Profit, and more importantly, how it may help in your trading, you may visit the website www.superiorprofit.co and click on the About link. Before we begin, we go through the standard disclaimer. This demonstration is for educational purposes only. It is designed to share information on Superior Profit's trading system. The information presented here should only be used by people who are aware of the risk inherent in trading. Past performance is no guarantee of future return. Superior Profit is not an investment advisor. This session is not for any recommendation of buying or selling stock or any other instrument. Superior Profit will have no liability for any investment decision made by its audience. In today's topics, we will study key commodities, oil and gold, using technical charts. The movement in these commodities sometimes helps us understand movement in related industries. Then we will study the broad market using market breadth analysis and market ETFs technical analysis. Studying the market breadth may give us insight that is not available from studying individual charts of stocks and indices. We study the broad market ETFs to understand the direction of the market and thereby try to align our trades with the market's direction. The market consists of multiple industries. The industries rotate from strength to weakness. We'll study that using performance graphs, ranking scoring and heat map table to see which industries are strong, which are weak, and equally importantly, which are strengthening and which are weakening. Thereby taking long trades only in the strong industries and short trades only in the weak industries. This adds additional edges to our trade's favor. Along the way, we may review some of the trade examples shared in our Q Traders forum and look for potential trades for the coming week. That was the last slide of the presentation. Let us move to live system now. We start our key commodities technical analysis with US oil. We are looking at USO using weekly backdrop template on the left side and daily hop-on template on the right side. Together, we call this template at-a-glance template. This is the template that helps us identify a potential trade at the right edge using Q unambiguous checklists. Last week in the weekly market roundup, I mentioned that US oil was moving sideways with the highs and lows at approximately same levels, and therefore I suggested staying away from taking any trade in this uncertain direction period. We see that uncertainty continuing this week. US oil is now inside a triangle pattern bounded by memory resistance at the top and memory support at the bottom. Unless it moves out of the triangle pattern in either direction, we are not sure of the trend, and it may be prudent to stay away from taking any directional trade in US oil right now. We are now looking at gold using same at a glance template. The weekly chart shows US oil declined for 2 weeks and then reversed somewhat in this week. The backdrop candle color continues to be magenta, that is bearish. In the daily chart, gold dropped sharply to the lower boundary, and in last 4 days it recovered somewhat. In the last market roundup, I had mentioned that price was already close to lower boundary. Therefore, we were not going to take any short trade. I also suggested that if GLD recovered somewhat and tilted down from the value area, that might give us a low risk go with flow trend following short trade opportunity. This week gold has recovered, it has come to the value area. Next week, if it tilts down, giving us a daily magenta color candle, that may be the signal to take a low risk short trade. Right now, there is no Q standard trade setup in GLD. Let's now study market breadth using NASDAQ composite index and NYSE composite index weekly charts. The indices themselves are in clear uptrend. Both NASDAQ and NYSE made another new all-time high. In past 2 weeks, NASDAQ was underperforming NYSE. That changed. NASDAQ outperformed NYSE in this week. Both NASDAQ and NYSE ended with traffic light candle color green, that is bullish color, and both are also overbought, that is shown by the stretch dots appearing on top of the candles at the right end. We study market breadth using three pairs of internals: new high lows, advanced declines, and up down volume. New high lows for both NASDAQ and NYSE went up. Advanced declines also went up for both the indices. Up down volume for both NASDAQ and NYSE not only went up, but they breached the peaks made in the past. These are the only two internals that could surpass previous peaks. The other four internals continue to remain below previous peaks. In summary, we may conclude that the indices are in clear uptrend. There is no doubt about it. The internals continue to be weak overall, not able to surpass previous peaks for most of them. For this specific week, internals are strong. All the six internals went up and all of them ended in the positive. Market breadth study shows a strongly bullish market that strengthened further in this week. Let's see if the broad market ETF study supports the same conclusion. We are studying SPY using at a glance template. In the weekly chart, SPY made a new all-time high, though the candle has an upper tail. In the daily chart, a bearish headwind appeared on Wednesday that pushed the price below the watermark resistance level. On Friday, price did recover, however closed just below the watermark resistance level. This week had very high activity. In the daily chart, Friday's activity was very high. Overall, this paints a bullish picture of SPY. We are now studying QQQ with at a glance template. QQQ went up strongly in the weekly chart, though activity was muted. It was not very high as was the case for SPY. On Friday, it had very high activity, just like in the case of SPY. SPY could not close above the watermark resistance, but QQQ closed clearly above the watermark resistance in the daily chart. This paints a strongly bullish picture of QQQ, and QQQ clearly outperformed SPY. Dia chart is similar to SPY. It made a new all-time high. Just like SPY had a bearish headwind signal day, Dia also had a bearish headwind on Thursday. Friday had a very narrow range, you may say a doji candle, that was also an inside day candle. Friday's activity was high, and as a whole, the week's activity was also high. Dia continues to be in strong uptrend. It is certainly bullish. The last broad market ETF that we study is IWM. IWM displayed a bearish headwind in the previous week, and this week it had a narrow range body with both upper tail and lower tail in the weekly chart. That is an indecisive candle. In the daily chart, the decline that started in the previous week turned into sideways movement in the current week. It hardly went up or down in the current week. Friday's activity was very high, and the weekly activity was higher than the previous week. This is the only broad market ETF that is not going up strongly at the right edge. All the other three ETFs, SPY, QQQ and DIA, are in clear uptrend. IWM is somewhat indecisive at the right edge of the chart. None of these ETFs have any standard Q trade setup as of Friday. From broad market study, we now move to sector analysis. We are studying sector performance of 11 sectors across 3 review periods. The red bar represents performance of this week. Green bar represents performance of 1 week prior to the red bar, and blue bar represents performance of 2 weeks prior to the green bar. Together, they constitute 4 weeks or about 1 month of performance. Any bar coming to the right of the zero line indicates the sector went up. Any bar coming to the left indicates the sector decline. This week, 7 of the 11 sectors gained, and the gains were considerably larger than the declines. This shows an overall bullish market that is in sync with the observation from market breadth analysis as well as broad market ETF analysis. Telecom is the best performing sector, going up by 4%. Using QH industry rotation, you could catch the exact bottom of this sector several weeks ago, thereby being ahead of most other traders. After a few weeks of muted performance, information technology went up considerably. From QH, you can see that this is the second best performing sector over last 5 days and the very best performer over 2 days and 1 day periods. This shows that information technology, after losing strength for a couple of weeks, regains its strength forcefully. Many of the strong stocks in this sector may be already at or near 52-week high. Therefore, before taking any new position in this sector, you may analyze the charts and the stock's fundamentals carefully. Financials score dropped with highest pace. Long position holders may put protect profit stop using Q protection signal, and you may also look for potential shorts in this sector. It not only dropped with highest pace, it also turned negative. Consumer staples and consumer discretionary sectors continue to go up. Using QH, you could catch the exact turning point of these sectors. Though both of them ended in the positive this week, there are some warning signs showing that consumer discretionary may be losing steam. Therefore, if you have a profitable position, you may protect profit using Q protection signal, and you may look for potential shorts of stocks that are either overvalued or are having poor growth. We'll look into it in more detail when we do the industry analysis. We are now looking at the best performance industries. Three of the best performing industries are in telecom sector. Remember that in the sector analysis, telecom was the best performing sector as well. This might have benefited from the net neutrality regulation change. However, using QA, you could catch these industries at a much lower level. All these three telecom industries are strengthening after long periods of weakness and may give swing as well as long-term buy opportunities. These three telecom industries are alternative carriers, diversified telecom services, and integrated telecom services. Out of them, alternative carriers is the best performing industry this way. Others may be starting to talk about it. However, you could catch this industry's turning point much earlier, as we did. I had shared a QH insight on CenturyLink CTL. This trade idea was tracked in the Q forum starting from 15th November, and that turned out to be a very profitable trade. Let's have a look at the post from Q forum. On 15th November, I had shared this thought in our traders forum. Is this optimal valued stock with 15% dividend yield a good buy? At that time, from QH, I saw that the telecom services sector, after languishing for a long time with magenta color, turned cyan, and the best performing sector over 1 day period. Drilling down I had observed that alternative carriers had the best rank at that time. And alternative carriers industry was also weak for many months. Just over 1 day period, it turned around. Using Q Vital fundamental analyst, I saw that CenturyLink CTL had the best possible relative valuation score. We could just look at the cyan color and conclude that it was optimally valued. And at that time, it had a dividend yield of 15%. There was no Q standard trade setup at that time. However, the trade setup came soon enough. We started tracking CTL from this candle, that is 15th November. Subsequently, CTL gave a bullish headwind signal, which was also a bullish headwind long trade setup on 28th November. As you can see, that bullish headwind caught the very bottom of the stock. Subsequently, on 8th December, there was another long trade setup, which was a go with flow trend following long trade setup. At the right edge, CTL hit the memory resistance line. Any swing trader taking a long at the go with flow setup or the bullish headwind setup might book profit, at least partial profit, and use Q protection signal to apply stop to make sure that the entire trade is risk free from this time onward. This was a great example of using Q edge industry rotation information to identify fundamentally strong stock, optimal valuation stock in this case. Wait patiently for a Q standard trade setup and then taking the trade confidently when the trade setup appeared. Other than the telecom industries, three more industries are turning around, as you may see from Q scores. This may give optimal valuation buy opportunities. You may drill down using Q edge to investigate further. I have drilled down into heavy electrical equipment. In this industry, Babcock and Wilcox Enterprises, ticker symbol BW, went up by 101% in 4 months. Q charts gave a go with flow long trade setup on 13th September. That trade turned out to be very profitable. Let's look at Q edge. Identify heavy electrical equipment as one of the best performing industries this week. Drill down to its stocks. Identify BW as one of them. And then look at Q technical charts to see how it went up significantly and how you could capitalize on that move by taking a go with flow long trade on 13th September. In QA, we have made some changes. Instead of using ranks for the sector and industry table, we have consistently used scoring. Therefore, any number, be it for sector analysis, industry analysis, or stock analysis, high shows that sector, industry, or stock is stronger. So we moved away from using ranking for the sector industry analysis. Every time we open QH in real time, QH analyzes 11 sectors and more than 170 industries, assesses them over 12 monthly review periods and then more frequently for recent periods over 10 days, 5 days, 2 days and 1 day. For each of the review periods, it assigns a score, high score, for the best performing item and a low score for the worst performing item, and also applies a heat map, cyan to the best performer, magenta to the worst performer, and color gradient to all the items in between. The result is a scoring and heat map table that instantly tells us which one is strong this week. Telecom sector is the strongest, which one is weak, utilities is the weakest. It also shows which item was weak earlier and strengthening now, consumer staples turning from magenta to cyan, and which sector was stronger earlier and weakening now, turning from cyan to magenta, as in the case of materials. To analyze the industries, we go to the industries tab, sort the industries over the primary 5 days period from largest to smallest. This shows the best performing industries at the top. Heavy electrical equipment is an industry that is strong over the primary 5 days period, cyan. Looking to the right, we see that it was weak, magenta, for many months, and now it is strengthening. So it may give us swing long opportunities as well as long term buy opportunities. You can click this button to drill down to the underlying stocks. QA goes to the universe, that is Thomson Reuters icon or Metastock Zenith, and retrieves the stocks. It has retrieved 9 stocks. Click the calculator button to retrieve data and calculate the vital statistics. You can see BW is one of the stocks in this industry. To analyze further, we may click the magnifying glass, the investigate button, get the data in vital analysis tab. From the performance panel, we instantly see that over 4 months period, BW went up by 101%. Over 3 months period, it went up by 52%+. Let's look at the chart. This is BW using hop-on chart. On this candle, it gave a go with flow long trade setup. Stop would be just below recent low. That was in fact the first possible trend following long trade setup in this stock. Since then, the stock went up considerably, resulting in a very profitable trade. We are now looking at the worst performing industries. 3 of the worst performers belong to consumer discretionary sector. Remember, I mentioned that though consumer discretionary turned upward from its bottom, in this week there are some warning signs that the industries are losing steam. This is one such indication. QH industry analysis provides detailed insight. 12 of the consumer discretionary industries lost score at high pace. and several of them turned magenta from cyan. These are signs of weakness. Let's study it in more detail from QH industry rotation table. In QH, we can go to sector analysis, look at consumer discretionary and click the components button. Then the industry analysis tab shows only the industries in consumer discretionary sector. When I sort the consumer discretionary industries from weaker ones, magenta, to strong ones from top to bottom, we see several of them are now turning magenta from cyan color. That is, they are weakening. If you sort the same industries using paste column, then we see that 11 of them are coming in bold case. That is, these 11 industries are some of the weakest. That is, they are losing score at high pace. Therefore, not only that several industries in consumer discretionary came in the worst performer list, they also lost score very fast. Both are signs of weakness. Coming back to the worst performing industries, the three consumer discretionary industries that are among the worst performers are consumer electronics, home furnishing retail, and automotive retail. I have drilled down into home furnishing retail and saw that Tier 1 imports dropped almost magically after hitting weekly memory resistance coming from far, far away. By looking at the memory resistance, you could be careful and protect profit in any long position that you might have. And if you are a fast trader, you could also take a short trade. Let's look at Tier 1 imports from Q charts. This is Tier 1 imports using at-a-glance template. This memory resistance line in the weekly chart is coming from very far away. And this week, it tried to go above that weekly memory resistance, failed, and declined sharply. By looking at the presence of this memory resistance, one might be cautious and use Q protection signal to apply stop to protect profit in any existing long position. That would be very wise, as PR1 imports dropped with a big gap down on Thursday. Interestingly, at the right edge, it is resting on top of a memory support line. Last three successive days had very or extreme high activities. Therefore, if it bounces up from the memory support line, in the daily chart, it may give us a bounce long trade opportunity. This is very interesting because we could watch the memory resistance and protect profit. And now, looking at the memory support, we may look for a bounce long trade setup. In the same home furnishing retail industry, two of the annual best performers, Restoration Hardware RH and Sleep Number SNBR, has displayed bearish headwind, and it may be wise to protect profit with Q stop. You may look up these two stocks and their bearish headwind signals using Q charts yourself. Another industry that performed poorly this week is oil and gas drilling. This was one of the worst score decliners in the previous week. Whenever an industry declines in score with fast pace, we see that it tends to become worst performer in subsequent weeks. That happened in oil and gas drilling in this week. It is now one of the worst performers. In this industry, Noble Corp NE gave a go with flow short setup on Wednesday 13th December that turned out to be a very profitable trade. Q Vital shows that NE also had poor growth that would provide additional conviction in shorting the stock. You may look up NE using Q Vital and identify the poor growth yourself. Let me look at NE using Q charts. We are looking at NE using at a glance template. In the weekly chart, we have two successive weeks of bearish candles, both in terms of backdrop candle color magenta, that is bearish, and also in terms of candle shape. Solid candles implying bearish shape candles. In the daily hop-on chart, on this candle, this Wednesday, we had a magenta flow color candle that gave us a go with flow short trade setup. Stop was just above recent high that was never hit. Instead, any dropped. It almost hit the lower boundary, so one could book partial profit at least at close of Friday. This is another example of a trade that could be initiated from top-down analysis starting from QH, or it could also be identified using bottom-up analysis using Q sonar on this day. This week's worst performer is consumer electronics. In this industry, GRMN, GRMN, dropped heavily. GRMN's drop was caught at the very top by Q headwind signal, and Q systems also signaled a go with flow trend following short on Tuesday, 12th December, this week, that hit profit target on Friday, 15th December. Let's look at the consumer electronics industry in QH, drill down to its stocks, identify GRMN, and then look up GRMN using Q technical charts. In QH, we short the industries over primary 5 days period, smallest to biggest score, that brings the worst performing industries to the top. Consumer electronics is the worst performer with a score of only 1, or we could just look at the magenta color. To drill down, we can click on this button that would retrieve the underlying stocks from Metastock Zenith or Consumerators icon. It has retrieved 7 stocks. You can click the calculator button to retrieve data and calculate vital statistics. This stock, GRMN, GRMN, is having poor growth. It is mid-valued, neither cyan or magenta. Let's look at the stock chart. This is GRMN using Q at a glance template. In the daily chart, the bearish headwind on this candle caught the very top beautifully. You can see there was another bearish headwind signal on this candle. However, that candle had a lower tail, which is bullish, and therefore we would not consider taking any short trade based on this bearish headwind signal. If the weekly chart was having yellow color candle, then this bearish headwind would give us a valid short trade setup. As the weekly chart is having yellow or magenta candle for past 3 weeks, we can imagine that when this bearish headwind came in daily chart, weekly candle was probably yellow. Therefore, this bearish headwind signal also gave us a bearish headwind short trade setup. That worked out beautifully. If you missed the bearish headwind reversal short trade, the next optimal short entry opportunity came on this candle. That was a trend following going through short trade setup. This was signaled this week, and in 3 trading days it hit lower boundary, that is the profit target for showing short trade, and Q traders would certainly book profit, at least partial profit. Another trade that could be identified from Q edge, taken confidently using the unambiguous trade setup checklist, the headwind trade setup or the going flow trade setup, both of which would end profitably. Every week we also study the industries going up with fast pace. This may often turn into the industries with best performance in subsequent weeks. Gold is the industry that gained score at fastest pace. As gold went up, AUY made a reversal right from the weekly memory support. At the same time, it completed a false reversal in the daily chart. From same level where a bullish headwind had appeared before. This could be taken as a buy signal that resulted in a profitable trade. Let's have a look at AUY using Q charts. This is AUY using at a glance template. Let me change the daily template to advanced hop on, which would also show the watermark support and resistance lines. In the weekly chart, there was a memory support line coming from far away. 1 week before, price tried to go below the memory support line, however, closed above it. And this week, AEY went up further. The weekly backdrop candle color turned cyan, that is bullish. Last week, when price was trying to go below the memory support line, it had also breached the watermark support in daily chart. However, closed above the same watermark support line, completing a false downside breakout. The fact that AUY could not close below the memory support in weekly or the watermark support in daily could be a signal to take a low risk long trade. If someone took that trade, it turned out to be very profitable as the stock went up strongly along with its industry, that is the gold mining industry. On Friday, it hit precisely the memory resistance in daily chart. Q swing traders would certainly book some profit at that point and may leave the remaining position with a stop using Q protection signal so that the entire trade is risk-free from now onward. Another industry that went up with fast pace is technology distributors. This was languishing for many months and is now gaining in score. In this industry, TECD and ARW both are optimally valued and may give low risk buy opportunity next week. Let's look at this industry, drill down to the stocks, and finally look them up using vital fundamental score and also using technical charts. In the industry analysis tab, I have now sorted the industries based on 5 days base column, with the biggest S industries coming to the top. Gold is the industry that went up with highest pace, and technology distributor is a close second. Technology distributor was magenta for many months and then turned cyan over 5 days period, improving score, and turned further cyan over 1 day period this Friday, thereby showing that it is getting stronger. You can click this button to drill down to underlying stocks. It has found 16 stocks. We can click the calculator button to calculate the vital statistics. We see these two stocks, TECD and ARW. Both are optimally valued. We can see that instantly from the cyan color and also from the high score. We could open these two stocks in Q charts. This is TECD. It is going up in the weekly chart. The weekly backdrop candle color is cyan. In the daily chart, it went up with a gap up move after earnings and then pulled back to value area and now moving sideways. TECD has already created higher high and higher low. Therefore, next week, if it moves up, gives us a cyan color candle, that would signal a low risk, go with flow, trend following long trade opportunity. What about ARW? ARW is resting just on top of support in the weekly chart, the memory support lines. The weekly candle color is indecisive, both in terms of color, yellow, as well as shape, having both upper and lower tails. In the daily chart, it is resting on top of the memory support and also the watermark support level. It has a cyan color candle on Friday. Friday price went up with very high activity. We see this price level is acting as support very well, around 77. Every time price tries to come to that level, it has gone up. And on Friday, it went up as well. Only concern about taking a long position in ARW right now is that there is memory resistance, actually two of them, very close to Friday's closing price. One may wait for price to go up, break above the memory resistance lines, tilt down and then tilt up again to give us a low risk, go with flow, trend following long trade opportunity. Lastly, we study the industries going down with fast pace. The second shows that the consumer discretionary industries may be losing steam. 6 of the consumer discretionary industries lost score with fast pace. You may be protecting profit in any long positions you are having and may even look for shorts. These 6 consumer discretionary industries that went down with fast pace are multi-line retail, departmental stores, specialized consumer services, automotive retail, diversified consumer services, and motorcycle manufacturers. I have drilled down into specialized consumer services and noticed that should this BID reverse precisely from weekly and daily memory resistance lines. It had poor growth relative to peers. It may give short trade opportunity in the coming week. Let's look at QH, identify specialized consumer services, drill down into underlying stocks, identify BID, and then look at its technical charts. In industry analysis, we are going to sort the industries on base column from smallest to largest. That will bring the stocks that went down with first base to the top. You can see specialized consumer services is one such industry. It was cyan in recent months but turned magenta suddenly over 5 days period, holding on to the magenta color over 2 days and 1 day period. We can drill down to the underlying stocks by clicking the get components button. It has retrieved 11 stock. Clicking the calculator button will retrieve the data of these stocks and calculate vital statistics. You see BID is a stock that has one of the poorest growths in this peer list. That caught my attention and I looked up the Q technical charts. In the weekly chart, BID reversed precisely from the weekly memory resistance line. At the same time, in the daily chart, BID displayed a bearish headwind and reversed from the daily memory resistance line. If you were watching BID, knowing the existence of these two memory resistance lines, you could short the stock on this day using fine-tune real-time 5-minute chart. Just as price tried to go above the memory resistance and failed and reversed, you could short precisely at this price level. Probably book some profit by the end of the day and hold on to the remaining trade with a stop so that the entire trade is risk-free from that time onward. On Friday, price tried to go up again and reverse precisely from the memory resistance line. Next week, if it goes down further, it may give us a low risk short trade opportunity, especially if the industry continues to go down. Steel is another industry that declined with fast pace. In this industry, ArcelorMittal MT has signs of weakness in Q charts. One may be careful about holding any long position and may even look for shorts. Let's again start from QH, look at the industry, and then look up MT using technical charts. Here is steel industry. It turned magenta over the primary 5 days period and was cyan prior to that, and it reduced score very fast, being the second worst score decliner in this week. MT is a stock in this steel industry. Interestingly, it has displayed a bearish headwind signal in the weekly chart, and in the daily chart, it has moved down from the very top. Based on higher highs and higher lows, it is still in uptrend. There is no standard Q trade setup. Next week, if it recovers a little bit and goes down, it may give us a very low risk short trade opportunity. The trade may be taken more confidently if the steel industry continues to weaken. Let us summarize today's analysis. Market breadth, broad market ETFs, as well as sector analysis shows overall bullish market. One sector, consumer discretionary, that was turning up from the very bottom is showing some signs of weakness. Therefore, you may be careful about holding long stocks in this sector. As the overall market is bullish, there is no need to exit any profitable long position. You may continue to hold them and be careful about shorting any stock. Shorting only if the industry for that stock is weak and the stock also shows weakness, both in terms of fundamentals as well as technical charts. That is all that I wanted to share in today's session. Thank you for joining. I look forward to seeing you in our next session. Have a great weekend and trade profitably.